The heroic raid and the legendary raid have the exact same mechanics. It's the same map. Just pretty much everything's the same. It's everything is the same. It's just, scaled for legendary. So I want everybody who's new to go ahead and pull that graphic up now. And just go ahead and take a couple minutes to look at it. And then I'll start explaining how this is going to work. So here's the graphic that they're looking at now. And so this is going to be, we're going to be doing what's called the H method, which is also called the collapse method. And the reason why it's called that, the H method, is because if you look at the paths that both sides run, it kind of forms an H up and down the sides and then collapsing in the center. And so there's ZZ and her three little puppies right there. And so the tank will run in the center and grab ZZ's aggro and the three puppies. Now, if you're doing this on legendary, you can just, you can use a throwing weapon or, even a spell to grab the puppy's aggro. They sometimes will just like try to run off right away. On heroic, you don't want to do that because they don't. So on heroic, you wouldn't want to like hit them with a spell or a throwing weapon because they don't have that many hit points. But on legendary, they have a ton of hit points. So the tank's gonna go in there with the healer, grab ZZ's aggro and the puppies, and then the left and right group are gonna go to the north corner, kill a mind flayer here, drop due south to number two, kill a mind flayer here, grab the control stone there, and they grab the control stone in the north too, and then they go up and in and then take their positions here. So it's one, two, three. And so they're facing out a third of the way from the center, and the idea is that they don't. The trash that's running by, they won't even, most of it won't even aggro on these people. And so this is the reason why the H method is superior to the circle method, is because when you do it right, you deal with very, very little trash. And so what you want to do if you're one of these people here that's hanging out guarding the center, is that if you see any trash come in, you want to run out to meet it, especially if it's a beholder, because you don't want any trash to come into the center. It can screw things up. So here's how this is going to work. So you can see ZZ, that's the boss, and her three little puppies. Now she cannot be damaged through normal means right away. And the only way that she can be damaged at first is by charming her puppies. And then they attack her. They can bust through her DR. Nobody else can. And the way that we charm the puppies is not through normal charming means. There's actually these control stones that drop from certain mobs in here that we pick up, and then we use the control stones by putting them in our hot bars, and then targeting the little puppies and clicking on the control stones to charm them. It's a special mechanic unique to this raid, so it's not like a charm that they would save against or make a recurring save against. It's just timed. So that's something that, like, some people that don't know this raid really well all don't realize. They think, like, they'll say things like, don't give them greater heroism because it'll make them save against the charm. That's not true. Like I said, there's no save against the charm, and it's just timed. You can examine them to see how much time is left on the charm. And so what we're going to do is we're going to have a tank go in and grab ZZ's aggro, and the tank wants to try to grab the puppies too, because the puppies, for whatever reason, when you first go in there, they disperse to the outer halls, and we want them to stay there. So the tank will do his best to just keep all the dogs in the center and hold them till the rest of us get there. So there's going to be a tank and like maybe a healer that goes in the center, and then everybody else. So there'll be 10 people left. We'll be separated into two groups of five. It'll be a left and right group. And the left and right groups will run, left and right and go to the north corner. And there's going to be a mind flayer there that you're going to kill, and it'll drop a control stone. And I'm going to designate somebody to pick those up. So you want to make sure that you don't just randomly pick that up. It's just a certain person should pick those up. so that you know who has them, and they'll be designated to pass them off to the person who's going to do the charming. After you go to that north corner and kill the Mind Flayer and pick up the Control Stone, you're going to then turn around and go due south and go to the south corner, so the corner that you can see from here. And there'll be another Mind Flayer there. He won't be there the first time you pass it. That's why you go to the north corner first. So you drop to the south corner, you're going to kill the Mind Flayer, then somebody will grab the Control Stone, and then you'll go back north and then cut through the center hall. So the reason why this one's called the H method, the method that we're learning now, is because that path that you form sort of forms an H. You go up and down the sides and then cross the center to form the cross of the H. And this is as opposed to like the circle method or the O method, and the H method is also called the collapse method. And these two methods are just different ways of mitigating trash. So throughout the raid, there's going to be trash that spawns from these portals, like this portal we're standing at. But the reason why I like the H method is because if you do this method right, most of the trash will not even aggro on the center group. It'll just keep running around this outer ring. Like the map is kind of like a big ring with a cross going through the center. And so you just let that trash run by. You just wave to it as it runs by, and you never even have to deal with it. Now, some trash will aggro on the people in the center. And so once you do sort of the outer portion where you grab the control stones and you go to the center, everybody will take a position in a hall. There's going to be two people positioned at each hall, about a third of the way out from the center, facing outward. It's very important that you're facing outward because you need to be able to see trash that might potentially, or that is coming into the center. It's very tempting to watch the fight in the middle, but it's important that you don't, because you need to intercept trash before it gets in the middle. If trash gets in the middle, it can screw things up because it can start attacking the dogs, the puppies, and it can kill them, or it can take the aggro of the puppies off of Xyzzy. And it's important for the puppies to be attacking Xyzzy. So you're going to be one third of the way out from the center, facing outward, and you just stand and watch for trash to come in that might come into the center. If it starts coming in the center, you're going to run out to meet it, kill it, and then retake your post. It's very important to not allow trash to get in the center, especially if it's a beholder, because the beholder's anti-magic can dispel the charms of the dogs and really screw things up. So if you see a beholder especially, you want to run out and kill it and then retake your position. And the first round of beholders that comes, they're like little baby beholders. They look like the companion beholders. So they're very easy to miss. And so what we're going to be doing in the center is, you know, we'll be charming the dogs, and a tank will have ZZ's aggro. The dogs will be beating on Xyzzy. And then after one round of charms, which is like 2.5 minutes, we'll recharm them. And then once Xyzzy is beat down to about 25% health, then she becomes vulnerable to normal attacks. She can't be hurt by spells, but she can be hurt by like weapons and stuff. Untyped damage, I think, from spells will work against her, though, like ruin. Once she's vulnerable, but not like, you know, firewall or stuff like that. So the outer groups grab control stones, then collapse in the center, taking positions in the hallways, while the center group, while the tank keeps Xyzzy's aggro off the dogs. The dogs beat Xyzzy down to 25%. Then we all collapse on Xyzzy and kill her, and then it's over. That's the nutshell version. I know what you're thinking, that it's confusing and overwhelming. That's okay. Remember, this is the heroic instance. Everybody feels a little overwhelmed at first. If things go wrong, it's okay. It's just heroic. Like, we're way overpowered. We're not going to screw things up. But I will say this. Someone once described this raid to me as the easiest raid you'll ever wipe. It's really easy for things to go wrong here. This can be a very technically challenging raid. But most groups should be able to recover a heroic hound with no problem. So there are the jobs. The left team is going to be Sly, Hack, Da Vinci, Sohu, and Oprecious, and Hakuna will grab the control stones. The right team is going to be Skadi, Twizzer, Psycraft, Ginger, and Tornil. Ginger will I'll grab the control stones. And then Bolo, who's going to tank, and Slingbot are going to go into the center right away. So we want to let Bolo get just a few seconds head start to establish aggro before the left and right teams take off. So we've got, I've got a whole bunch of... What did you say?
Ask Bolo if he's going to be able to survive.
I'm sending Slingbot in there to keep him healed in case there are any problems. But I would seriously hope that he can survive against Heroic Xyzzy. Make sure you have any guards taken off. You don't want the puppies to be damaged by any guards that you have Bolo. Cool. Okay, any questions before we get started? When this raid's done right, it takes 5 minutes, and it seems super easy. When it goes wrong, it seems like the biggest pain in the butt ever. Kind of like Abbott, in a sense. Or Mark of Death. Okay. Bolo and Sling. Bolo first, go ahead. Left and right teams wait. If you see dogs on the outside, don't attack them. Left and right teams go. You're running to the north corner. Hack will grab the stones on the left. I'll grab the stones on the right. We got a puppy on the right, so watch the AoEs. I got one stone. You want to drag it from your inventory into your hotbar.
You're going to do the charming? Or?
I will do the charming, yep. Just bring that puppy in. Right team's coming in. Go ahead and
get back.
Go ahead and take your positions.
In the middle, follow me.
Yeah, everybody come on into the middle.
Oh, I just screwed up this control stone because oh, it worked. Sweet. We're going to be charming just two dogs.
Okay, you two just follow me, stay where I am.
I want a High Lord and a non-High Lord to be in each hall. So, like, right now, like, Hakuna and Oprecious, you guys can hang out here. Da Vinci and Sohu, I want you to go to a different hall. One High Lord and one newbie for at each hall. So there's nobody, there's no High Lord with Twizzer.
There's no High Lord. Vinci, back center. Don't go that far out.
Psycraft, I want you to come over here to your left. And hang out with Sohu and Twizzer so you guys are... Okay, if you are new to the raid, I want you to go ahead and, you know, you can watch the center, but make sure you don't watch for too long. And the person who's doing the charming of the dogs, if they have, like, druid past lives or augment summoning or something like that, that all works on the dogs. So, it's, you know, you always want to, like, try to have somebody doing the charming that has, you know, has that stuff. You can also put, like, bulls and bears on them. You can do haste. But some, for whatever reason, some buffs don't take, like the spell GH or Rage doesn't seem to take to them for whatever reason. In Heroic, the dogs don't have very many hit points, it's easy for them to die by accident, but in Legendary they have a ton of hit points. Now, so what you're doing is you're facing the outside a third of the way out, and the idea is that you're not so far out that you're going to attract the attention of the trash. Just let it run by it. But if something starts coming in after you, you run out to meet it, kill it, and then retake your position. And the tank, Bolo Grub in this case, it's ideal if the tank is an intimid tank and can grab ZZ's aggro and keep ZZ's aggro off of the dogs, especially in heroic, because ZZ can kill her puppies really fast. As you can see, you can examine the dogs and see how much time is left. Oh, Hack, you didn't pass me the stones, man.
I'm right behind you.
Thank you. So when you're charming, you want to make sure you put some distance between you and the dogs. It's really easy to screw them up like I almost did. Earlier I got lucky that it auto-targeted to the next dog instead of like ZZ or some other crappy target.
You want me to drop consecration on them?
No, that's okay.
He'll do 10% more damage.
Oh, okay, yeah, go for it. I don't think we're gonna need it, but what the hell. So like I said, if you're new to the raid, I want you to take a few seconds to look at the center and see what's happening. And if you have questions, please ask. Now, if we were doing the circle method, you would be aggroing all of the trash throughout the entire raid and constantly fighting trash while there was just a few people in here doing this stuff. The problem with the circle method is it's very easy for trash to sneak in while that circle group, you know, is running on the opposite side of the map. But the idea is like with the circle method, it's just a crew on the outside that keeps you running around the outer ring, taking care of all that trash. This is a little more technically challenging, this method. So the circle method's, you know, better for pugs, you know, especially if you have like a lazy leader that doesn't want to try to explain the H method, which like it, you know, is more intricate. But this method, like I said, it's superior because, you know, when you do it right, you don't have to deal with much trash at all. You want to have a healer keeping an eye on the dogs to keep them healed, which is especially important in heroic because, like I said, they don't have a lot of hit points. If you have decent buffs on them, you usually just have to do two rounds of charming on elite. But there you go, Da Vinci, that you want to run out just like you did and meet it. You don't want to ever, like, range the beholders in. See, okay, I want everybody to look and see what happened. Now, that beholder got too close to the center and actually dispelled the charm of the dog. So that this is one of the things that can go wrong. Not a big deal. We might still be okay, but if we need to, what we're going to do is just send people out, a couple self-sufficient people, that will go out and get more control stones. After a while, more of those mind flares spawn that drop the control stones, and we just go out and get more of them. But we'll just send like a couple people. We don't want to send everybody. The people that are stationed at the hallways want to stay there. You don't want to abandon your hallways. Okay. We were just short. ZZ's almost ready to go, but the charms ran out. So what I want... Oh, is it? I missed the message. Oops. That was it, guys. That's how it works. That's funny. It was like the perfect time. So one, a couple more things. There's sort of an ideal place to tank ZZ, and I'll get your candy bag over here. And that is, you can see this hallway here in the east is a lot longer than the other hallways. So some people like to tank Xyzzy just inside here because it puts the longest distance between like the beholders coming in from the outside to where Xyzzy and her puppies are. Alright, let's loot. Congrats on your first Hound of Xoriat completion, guys. And we're going to do the legendary raid immediately after this. Okay, the jobs are exactly the same, except I'm going to be tanking and DJ's going to take my spot as the charmer, except I switched your sides, just so you could see the opposite side, it's the same, but just so that you could, you know, see a little bit more. So going right will be Sly, Jackie, who will grab the stones, Da Vinci, Sohu, Oprecious. Left, we Baz, Twizzer, Psycraft, and DJ, who will grab the stones. DJ will be our charmer this time. And Tornil's also going left. In the center is going to be me and Slingbot. So one thing I want to emphasize too is that, you know, some people will say, you know, this that the legendary takes longer, you know, because Xyzzy got more hit points and stuff. If you have really good dog buffs, you can still do this in two rounds, at least on hard. Maybe on elite it's going to take longer, but on hard we can do it in two rounds of charming just like we did in the heroic. But if you just have, you know, mediocre buffs or no buffs at all for those dogs, it will take considerably longer. So it's, you know, bard songs are great too for the dogs. So a lot of people like to have a bard in here for that too. Any questions before we get started? Last second buffs. Okay, give me a few seconds to get the aggro of everything in the center. Just hit everything with a spell. Left and right teams go. So this is legendary hard, just going to show you, it's 186 AC, doing 13 PRR, won't be any problem whatsoever. I haven't tried legendary elite yet, hopefully very soon. We're going to charm two dogs again and we're going to kill off the third dog, but we're going to wait until DJ charms before we kill off that third dog. My negative energy guard on my armor is hitting the dogs. It's okay though, they have so many hit points, it's not gonna be a problem.
Okay, I have two stones heading to center.
You'll notice one dog is like at half. Don't charm that one. Kill off that third dog as soon as you can. See, when I have the tank, grab Xyzzy's aggro away from the puppies. Kill off the third dog again. Everybody should, we should be positioned at the halls, a third of the way out, facing out. Also want to emphasize that if you are a range tune, you never want to shoot across the center at trash, because you can pull trash through the center, which can screw things up. Remember to meet beholders out as far as possible away from the center, because they can break the charms like they did last run. So with the druid, like if I was the one who was doing the charming, I could cast pack strength on him and it would take. But since I didn't do the charming, I can't cast pack strength on him. I can still do like bears and bulls and other, but some of the druid specific like buffs, like pack strength that affects your pack, then you know it has to be the druid itself that does the charming. So the charmer wants to keep an eye on the dogs to see. How much time left they have on the charm, so you can see 130 left.
Don't stand guard, Da Vinci. I'm just fine.
Dogs are tearing her up. This should be a two-rounder, no problem. And just a heads up, guys, if you join a pug, you most likely will be doing the circle method. So part of me says, you know, I should just teach that method, but hopefully you'll run into some people that teach it this way, or maybe you guys will go on to lead it this way. Either way, it's important to know that both methods are just about mitigating trash, keeping trash out of the center.
30 seconds left on the charm with puppies.
Wow. We're making really good time. ZZ's almost at half, and we're only through one round of charms.
Yeah, those puppies are buffed really well.
Hell yeah, they are.
Okay, puppies are recharmed.
So that dog there looks like it's not attacking anything, but if you do a target assist, you can see she's targeted on Xyzzy. Remember, run out to meet trash, then retake your position. Don't let trash come in the center, especially beholders. Beholder anti-magic can kill this raid. So I got the bees here, and one of the things I've noticed is that like the bees don't—you don't seem to get the blinding effect in Legendary. I don't know why, or what that's all about. I've got bees right now, so if you can keep me healed, Slingbot, I've got bees for another 30 seconds. So you have two people in the center, like a tank and a healer, and then you have two people at each hall, that's 10 people, that leaves two people, and so usually what I like to do is have two people designated as a floater to sort of help the other halls as needed, and then those are the people that will run out and get more control stones if needed. So everybody will stay at their hall except for those two floaters. Now, so I think there might be something wrong now. When I was on DDO cast, Patrick was talking about how sometimes the dogs will be charmed and they're not really attacking anything. And ZZ's health is not really going down much. Not like it should have been. Like, it should have been over by now. And so I think that there's we're gonna have to do another round of charming. I don't have bees anymore. Okay, we only have 10 seconds left on charming. Okay, so let's have two self-sufficient people run out and get more stones. How about Bazinga and DJ? Everybody else should be at a hallway.
I'm a stone.
Yeah, it's fine. Bazinga, let's go out to the west here, please.
There's a keeper on the south. Could be holders as well.
You need me to come down and help you?
Yeah, go over there and help, Sly. They're getting a little overwhelmed over there in the south hall.
Whoa.
Oh, Precious, go to the south hall and help him out real quick. Sohu, you stay where you're at.
South's clear.
Is it? Okay. Retake your positions. Slingbot incoming.
Yep.
Okay, you got two stones.
So I'm glad things kind of things didn't go as
six levels.
Who has neg levels?
Twiz.
And we're getting lit up over here in these guys.
Floaters to the east.
Thank you.
So it's good that things didn't go as planned, because it lets you see, you know, sort of what can go wrong.
Thanks, sir.
Beholder, big beholder.
So the longer this goes on, the more trash that comes, and you start getting these big beholders that come out, and they can be really problematic for
you're out way too far.
For lesser tunes. Oh, Precious, yeah, you're out too far, too. Sly, Oh, Precious, and Sohu, you guys can all come back just about maybe like 15 feet or so. There you go. I don't see anybody in that north hall. Do not pull that beholder in here, Twizzer. You can't range beholders. You gotta run out and meet them. Yeah, our dogs just got debuffed. They lost their charms. Because that big beholder got in the center. So it's a good example of what not to do. But I'm glad that happened, because it lets you see, you know, this is the time to do that, so that you don't go on a pug and do that and then get yelled at.
Yeah, glad I can help. Okay, thanks.
So we're going to need more stones. Baz and DJ, go ahead and go back out.
Let's go out east this time.
Another thing, Twiz. Unless it actually
starts to come in,
don't even shoot it. I didn't
hear that, sorry.
I was saying, unless the mob actually comes in the hallway, don't even shoot it.
Oh, okay.
Yep, you just let it run by. If it starts to come in after you, then you want to go out and meet it. But don't aggro it if it's not aggroed on you.
Okay. Thank you.
Yep.
This raid can go sideways in a hurry, can it?
Beholder West. Don't abandon your hallways, though.
Don't strike from inside.
Sax, can you help out in the west, please?
Oh, I'm dancing.
Beholder in the north.
And in the south.
Too much trash.
And he is secure.
He's in the north.
Yeah, Bazinga and I are down in the southeast.
Yeah, we got two beholders in the middle. So.
Oh, it's okay. We don't have any dogs charmed, so that beholders getting in the middle is not an issue right now.
Go ahead and bring trash to the center. That way you don't. Somebody else doesn't spawn and get it pissed too.
Just work on trash. Everybody just work on trash in the center. Don't panic. Okay, start panicking. Bazinga incoming.
Can gibber in the mirror if you want.
So who incoming? Oh fuck.
Woo!
Yes, can you
res? Just through.
I'm gonna go ahead and gibbers. Everybody who's got a gibbers, let's go ahead and gibbers on the count of three.
I don't know what that means.
It's okay. If you don't know what that means, then that means you don't have one. Okay, on three. One, two, three. Don't worry about little dogs. Just worry about killing trash.
Coming back. Or not.
Wow.
We're probably going to have to reform. That's okay. This was a great example of how this raid can seemingly be going perfectly, and then it just goes to hell. Like, super fast. Because, you know, the dogs become uncharmed, or... You know, in this case, the dogs weren't doing damage to Xyzzy for some reason, and I don't know how to correct that. That's like that's a bug. So had they been damaging Xyzzy, this would have been over 5 minutes ago. If the Beholder didn't get into the center and break the charms that third time, this would have been over. But like I said, I'm glad this happened because it's a perfect example of what goes wrong. Go ahead and recall out, and we're going to do it again. So to sort of recap, what went wrong there is some sort of bug where the puppies weren't attacking Xyzzy. So that, like, we lost a whole round of charming because of that. And had that not happened, we would have been done. And then the second, so when we did that third round of charming, a beholder got into the center and broke those charms. And so, and then we sent people to get a fourth round of stones, and then there was just too many. That's, you know, the longer you're in there, the more trash spawns, and then the big beholders come out if you're in there too long, and you saw what happened. And that's just, that's how this raid fails. It happens all the time. So I don't want you to feel like you guys did something wrong. Like, it just happens. But you'll know what to look out for. So we're going to do Legendary Hard again. And, you know, if it goes as planned, then it should be really easy. But shit happens. That was a really, really awesome example of how just little things can go wrong and you get overwhelmed and what are you going to do? Just recall and don't get frustrated and just go back in. We're doing exactly the same jobs as last run. Okay, I'm going to go in first. Left and right teams go if you haven't already. Xyzzy will overrun you too, so if you're tanking, it's good to have, like, Stand Against the Tide or some ability that makes it so that you can't get knocked down.
Two stones coming this way.
Kill the third dog, please. Another dog spawn, kill it real quick, please. Let's get some buffs on the dogs. If anybody's got bard songs, you can do those too. I think you got those though, don't you, DJ?
No, I have no bard levels.
Oh, okay, Da Vinci's got it. I knew I saw somebody playing songs.
A precious, can you stay with Bernio, please?
Repeat that? I didn't hear you.
Can I stay with Tornil?
He wants you to go north where Tornil is.
Yeah.
There's only one person there.
Thank you.
DJ, do you have the third and fourth stone?
Yes, I have two more stones.
Okay, great. Well, they're tearing her up again. What could go wrong? I think that was the first time we ever failed a teaching raid. It's a humbling experience.
Heavily inspired.
Yep, me too.
30 seconds left on puppy bus.
So once again, the first round, we're getting ZZ down to about half, which is awesome. Another thing you want to be careful of that's worth mentioning is your augment summoning necklaces, the Necklace of Mystic Eidolons. You do not want to use them in here because the shadows that proc spawn from them will actually attack the dogs even when they're charmed, and they do a lot of damage.
And they do.
And puppies rebuffed.
Great. So early, you know, in the last run, I checked, I did a target assist on the puppies when it looked like they weren't attacking anything. And when I did target assist, it said they were attacking ZZ. But she wasn't taking any damage. It looks like she is taking damage now, guys, so this is going to be over real quick. And this is going to be a textbook run. I've got bees, Slingbot, so if you could keep an eye on my health. Make sure you're watch. Make sure everybody's watching the outside hall. Don't let beholders or trash get in the middle. In about 30 seconds, ZZ's going to be ready to blow. So as soon as the aggro of ZZ goes onto the puppies, I intem her right back. That way she's not damaging them. About 15 seconds. There it is, everybody on ZZ. What a difference between that run and last run, huh? It's a perfect example of the difference between things going as expected, as planned, and things going wrong. And how easy it can seem when things go right, and how awful it can be when things go wrong. Congrats on your first Legendary Hound of Xoriat completion, guys. If you have any questions about either raid, let me know. And good luck on your loot.